guys, I just finished making these tiny little greeting cards. It's from my new collection, the Cheekies collection. These are little fairy cards and they're blank inside. You can use them from the Tooth Fairy or someone likes little fairies, and they even have little envelopes. So these are 3.5 by 2.5 inches, so quite small. But I just thought I would put up a video on how to make a classic greeting card template, and you can adjust it to any size depending on how big your greeting card is. So it's used on Photoshop, and let me know if you have any questions. But I just wanted to show you these little cards first since I just finished them. All right, thanks guys. Okay, so let's create a new template, and we're going to use a letterhead template, which is 8.5 by 11 inches. We're going to make sure that we use the CMYK color. 300 dpi is pretty good. And hit create. So once we're here, the first thing that we want to do is create a card template. So we're going to use our rectangular tool, make sure that we have a solid stroke and no fill. We're just going to pull open a rectangle. And we can adjust the size. So an A6 card is 6.25 inches by 4.5 inches. So go ahead and make those adjustments so you get bang on the exact size that you need. And what we can do is go ahead and duplicate this layer again. I am not using any of my shortcuts, so I'm trying to show you how to do this without shortcut keys, so bear with me here. All right, I've duplicated the layer, now I just need to move it down. So we're now essentially creating the front and the back of the card. Just adjusting using my arrow keys up and down just to get it right on. Now we're going to rasterize each one of these layers, and then we're going to go ahead and merge them together. So just hover over those two layers, use your command key, and then merge them together. All right, so now we need to switch this canvas just so I can do it the way that I would normally be looking at my cards. Makes it easier for me, move it around. And then what we want to do is rename this to template. So this technically is our card template, this layer. We're going to move it over and just center it. Make sure you have your rulers open. So I know that the 5.5 mark, 5.5 inches is the center because my card is 4.5 and 4.5. And I'm just going to make sure that I have it completely centered as well, height and width. It looks like it's already automatically centered, but I'll just check. Yep, that's right. 1.15, and yeah, okay, so now it is perfectly centered. You don't have to have it centered, but if you're going to print on the inside, you'll want to have your card perfectly centered. So now we're going to go ahead and add our cut lines. Here again, we'll use our rectangular tool, and we're just going to make sure that this time the line, I use a dotted line just so I can tell the difference when I'm doing it. And again, I'm going to line it right up. Use the rulers. You can see if you have any difficulty, you can hover your mouse over. But it really helps just if you can line it directly up. I'm going to pull over my rectangle and try to get it exactly on. And you can use your back and forth arrows if you need to. I'm going to click enter once I'm happy and have it all lined up. Some adjustments there. And what I'm doing is using my arrow keys. I'm going to go up to the top and just make sure it's exactly 9 inches here in the width level. So that way I know I'm going to be exactly over top. It looks a little bit off to me. All right, there we go. Perfect. Now we're going to go ahead and create the cut lines again using
What am I doing here? Oh, sorry. I'm a bit of a perfectionist. I want it to be exactly lined up. Okay. Here we go. All right, now back to our rectangular tool. And we're gonna hover over. Always make sure you're on the outside of the canvas. And then I'm lining up using my ruler again just to make sure I'm exactly over. That looks about right. I'm gonna click enter. There we go. And now I'm gonna go to my pen tool and just, this is gonna be the fold line. So just do it exactly, lining up with the ruler, 5.5 inches. Right over top. Perfect straight line. And then I'm just gonna rasterize all of these layers. And I'll merge them together as well. So in order to create the cut lines so you have some space, when we're all done here, just merging these layers. Okay, all the layers are merged. I'm going to go to my marquee tool now, and we're just gonna do it. This doesn't have to be spot on. This can just hover over, do a rectangle, and then you're gonna click delete, and it's gonna get rid of, oh, my fold line didn't go right. Hold on, what have I done wrong here? Let me figure this out. I must have an extra layer somewhere that I didn't realize. Yep, there it is, okay. Let me just click on that, click delete. There we go, and merge these two together. I'll move the shape and the rectangle. Somehow I created an extra one, I'm not sure how. Anyways, we'll go up to select, deselect, it gets rid of it, and there you go. Here you can, I'm just merging these two layers, and then you have your template for a card. So I'm just gonna rename these the cut lines, and I've got my template layer, and we're good to go. Perfect. Hope that makes sense. So what we're gonna do now is just show you how to add the artwork. I'm sure you can do this, but we're gonna make a new one, a new canvas, and I'm gonna go 4.6 by 6.45. I'm adding just 1/10 of an extra inch because I'll show you why to overlap. So let's just make a new layer here and go grab some artwork. I already have my little monkey. I made him before, so we're just gonna go ahead and copy him, just the one layer, not the background. I'm gonna copy him and then go ahead and paste him on this new layer. And I'm going to scale him up a little bit. So let's just go ahead and hit edit, transform, scale, if I can get it, scale, and make him a little bit bigger so he fits on the card. Looks about right. Let's just go ahead and apply the transformation and then move him with the move tool. Okay, good. Now maybe we want to write something at the top of the card. So I'll hit my font. Let's write, have a wonderful day. Make sure it's black. The writing. There we go. Kind of small. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger. So let's, we'll need to highlight that. So let's make the writing 30, no, hold on. Gotta highlight it. 30 points, no, that's too big. Okay, let's go down to 24. Perfect. Okay, my move tool, just gonna move it around. And then I think I want to add the background color right now. The background layer is white. Let's make it blue. So I'll pick my color. That's what I want. Yeah, that's good. Okay, we'll go with that blue. Okay. Go to the paint bucket tool. and make sure that I'm still in my background layer. I'm going to click the paint bucket tool, and there we go. We've got our blue background now. Perfect. So I'm just going to highlight all three layers because I need to copy them. So go ahead with my command key and hold my command key down while I hit each one of these layers. And edit, copy, and then edit, paste. There we go. And with the move tool, we're just going to move him over. And here you can see why I made it a little bit bigger. So you can see your cut lines. And I'm just going to adjust this up and down with my arrow key. And so there's my cut lines. In the middle is my fold line. You may want to go over the fold line a little bit, but you don't have to. Okay, so now on the back of the card, I'm going to write what I would, the cheeky little card company, that is my company. So we'll just write that name. And if you're selling your cards to stores, you always have to write on the back where it was printed. So you can say printed in California, you can say printed in the city, California, printed in the USA, but you have to say where it was printed. And then I always add like a stock number so I know which card it is if someone wants to reorder it. So then if you wanted to write something, here we go. I'm going to show you now what it looks like. So here's your actual card that you would print. You've gotten rid of your template lines, but now you know where to cut once it's printed off. Okay, now if you wanted to write something on the inside, you just go ahead and write it. This would go on the inside of the card. So what should I write? Have a wonderful day. Let's do it. 24. You cheeky little monkey. Cheeky monkey. There we go. That fits in. And then you just have to make sure that you hit the transform button. Edit, transform, and then you're going to rotate it 180 degrees because it's going to be upside down. This is how it works for me when I'm printing something. So that's big. Let's just adjust that. I don't know why that's big. Let's go highlight that. That font is too big. Okay, taking it down. There we go. Okay, and this is really it. So here's your card. I'll show you here. No, not the cut line, sorry. Get rid of the template lines, and let's get rid of the inside writing. There we go. So there is one side of your paper that you would print, and there, let's get rid of the front, there is the other side. All your cut lines match up. You could even send this off to a professional printer if you wanted to do large volumes, and they would print for you. And you're all done. I hope you enjoy this template on how to make a greeting card with Photoshop. All right. Thanks so much. Bye.